You've made it. I almost thought you weren't gonna make it. I know it seems like nobody's here, and you're probably at home watching this right now, but we wanted to do church this way this morning, just for you, so you still can learn a Bible lesson. Let's go get you checked in. Miss Rachel and Brother Josiah are your teachers today, and they're actually gonna do a great job at teaching you the Bible story and singing the songs with you. You ready to go? Come on. Me today, Miss Rachel.
Oh, okay. Well, are you gonna get them signed in?
Right, I'm printing out their tag right now. Let me get this one here, and we're gonna get you guys in. Here you go.
Let's take you to your classroom. Follow me. Come on, let's go. Wait, slow down. Thank you for waiting for me. Thank you so much. All right, it's just around this way. Look who it is!
Hey, you made it! Awesome, how was your week today? Actually, you know what, that was really cool. Let's get you into this blue carpet right here and we'll sit you down. I'm so glad you're here today. This is awesome. Now, follow me while we're gonna do our fast worship song.
It's not a secret, it's not a fairy tale, it's not made up. Jonah was in a whale. 3 whole days, 1, 2, 3. The greatest treasure the world God's people wrote.
Have you ever had an earache or sore throat and had to go to the doctor? What happens when you and your mother get to the doctor's office? You have to wait. Why do you have to wait? To take your turn, of course. Today, our story is about a man who had to wait his turn. He had to wait a very, very long time. Listen, and you'll find out why. Inside the city of Jerusalem was a big pool. It had 5 porches around it, and every day these porches were filled with sick people. Mothers, fathers, grandmothers, grandfathers, aunts, uncles, and boys and girls. Some of the people could not walk, could not see, and could not hear. We know that they were all sick, or they would not have been by the pool. Why had all these sick people gone to the pool, though? What were they waiting for? They were waiting for the water in the pool to move. People believed that at a special time during the day, an angel would come down and move the water, making it bubble up. They believed that the first person to get into the moving water would be healed of all their sickness. No wonder so many sick people came to wait for the moving of the water. The porches were so full that they looked like the waiting room in a doctor's office. Many of the people were too sick to move quickly, even when they saw the water move. Some got so tired watching that they did not see the water when it first started moving. Some of the people could not move by themselves to get into the water. Only if a friend came and helped them did they have any chance at all. Since only the first person in was to be made well, many would be always made sad and disappointed. One day, a man lay there who had been unable to walk for a long time. If only he had a friend who could come and help him get into the water, he knew he could walk. How sad. Would you have been his friend? Would you help him if you could? One day, Jesus went to the pool. There, he saw all the people who had come to be made well. There, he saw the man who could not walk. Jesus knew all about this man. He knew he had been coming to the pool for many years. Jesus knew he did not have a friend to help him. He looked down at the man and said, "Would you like to be made well?" "Oh," said the crippled man, "I could walk if I could get into the pool when it bubbles, but I don't have a friend to help me. When I try to crawl down to the water, it takes me so long that someone else gets in it before me." Jesus knew how much the man wanted to be well. He knew this man needed a friend, someone to care about him, someone to help him. Jesus was that friend. He loved that man, and he said to him, "Stand up, roll up your mat, and walk." And just like that, the man was healed. He was well. Jesus had made him well. The man did exactly what Jesus told him to do. He stood up, rolled up his mat, and walked home. How happy he was. Did Jesus put the man in the pool when it started to move? No. Jesus just spoke, and the man was made well. It was a miracle. A miracle is something only God can do. Jesus can do miracles because Jesus is God. The sick man did not go looking for Jesus. He did not ask Jesus to heal him. How wonderful to know that God looks after us and takes care of us when we need help. A little later, Jesus looked for the man. He found him in the temple worshiping God. Jesus talked to him and forgave the man's sin. The man knew then that it was Jesus who had made him well that day at the pool. He felt so happy and thankful that he told everyone how Jesus had healed him at the pool. Some of the people who heard this good news were not happy. Instead of being glad the man could walk, they were angry. They were angry because Jesus healed the man on the Sabbath. The Sabbath was a special day people were to worship God and do nothing else. Jesus told the angry people that God always does good, and he was doing what his father told him to do. Do you think it was right for Jesus to heal the lame man? Yes, it was right. Jesus was the man's friend. Jesus loved him and wanted to help him, and he did.
Oh, boom, bow, gotcha, gotcha. Oh, you're gonna get it. Oh, yeah, take that, take that.
Hey, Sheepy.
Oh, hello. Boom, boom, take that. Is it the Bible verse time?
Yeah, can you pause it for 1 second so we can go over it?
It's the Bible verse time.
Let me help you out here.
Oh, thank you for that so much. Yeah, because my hands are so small.
Okay, yeah.
Psalm 23:1. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. That's the Bible verse. Say it with me. The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Now, can I get back to playing video games?
Isn't that what you've been doing all day?
Yes!
I guess.
But the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not
want. Okay.
All right, boom, bow, boom, boom.
Here, put your hair, put your headphones back on.
I don't need them. Boom, bow.
Oh, Leo's sleeping right now. We have to be really, really quiet. I'm going to gently nudge him awake. Hey, Leo.
Leo. Oh, hello.
Hey, how are you feeling, Leo?
I was just taking a nap. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Do you think you have some time to answer some questions?
Of course. I love Bible questions, and I always get them right.
Okay, question number one. Are you ready?
Question number one. I'm ready.
What kind of people waited beside the pool of Bethesda?
Oh, I like this story. Lifeguards, because they had to save people when they fall in.
No, not lifeguards.
Not lifeguards?
No.
Oh, my goodness. Who was it?
Sick people, remember?
Oh, yeah. They were waiting to get in the pool to get healed when the water stirred.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
And the first one in got healed, right?
Yes, the first one who made it into the pool when it was stirred got healed.
Yeah, I'd hate to be the second one. Okay, what's the next one?
Okay, question number two. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Who did Jesus heal?
Who did Jesus heal?
Yeah.
The first person in the pool.
No.
No, but I thought the first person in the pool got healed.
He did. The person did, but remember, Jesus healed somebody else.
Oh, did he heal the person who couldn't get in by himself?
Yes. Do you remember what was wrong with the person?
Yeah, he couldn't walk, right?
Right. He was crippled.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, that would not be nice to not be able to walk, and then you couldn't get into the pool to get healed, and Jesus healed that person.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. You ready?
Yep.
Question number three.
Number three.
How did Jesus heal him?
Oh, I don't think I know this one. Did he just tell him to take up his mat and walk?
Yes.
Oh, I got it.
Good job, Leo.
Yeah. Jesus can just tell us to be healed, and that's all we need is Jesus' word, right?
Right.
All right, that's an awesome story. Can I get back to my nap?
Yes, do you... Go ahead. Thank you.
Bye,
Leo.
Bye-bye.
Follow me while we're going to do our fast worship song.
Sunday. Can't wait to see you next week. Have fun.